And what you need the 30k cards for in this deck is what I think is the best win condition in the Dragon Ball Super card game right now. What's up, Joe Crew? It is me, Joku DMD, and I'm here today with a deck profile. So today we are talking about the boy, Android 16, Joyza's favorite Dragon Ball character and arguably one of my favorite characters of all time. Just, you know, really peaceful guy, really strong-willed, strong heart. And we recently learned that he's also the son of Android 21. Anyway, guys, if this is your first time here and you want to see Shrippums and deck profiles and Dragon Ball collectibles, make sure to hit that subscription button. It really helps me out if you could. If you're a returning member of the Joe Crew, thank you for coming back. Thank you for watching the show. And let's get into this deck profile. First things first, we got to talk about this guy. This is Android 16. So basically what he does is he has a permanent that ignores the energy exhaust of all Android 16 cards with arrival blue green. So if an Android 16 card has a skill that is arrival blue green, you can charge it in active mode on the turn that you charge it, ignoring energy exhaust. This is huge because this really gets in there. Now, his auto is when he swings, you can discard an Android and draw two cards, which is really, really good. Discarding and drawing two, I think, is much better than drawing one because it really allows you to continue seeing more parts of your deck. And in the event that you have to discard a super combo, the super combo is still kind of live with this guy, and I'll explain why and how that works later. But basically, when your life is at four or less, or you and your opponent have a total of five life between the two of you, you can flip this guy over, awaken, draw one, take your life down to five, and untap one. Now, when he's awakened, he still has the same permanent where you can charge arrival blue green Android 16s in active mode, and you can activate the arrival skills of those cards out of your energy area, and they will replace themselves with energy from the top of your deck. So you can basically arrival cards out of your energy area and continue gaining value by continuing to build your energy. Once per turn, also, he has an activate battle where you can take a blue green Android from your drop area and combo with it. So he essentially has a 10k combo on his defensive and offensive step every turn. So the downside is that he doesn't draw. But what's cool about it is you have a free access to a super combo every turn, which it kind of in a way sort of replaces the drawing. I think he'd be a little too overpowered if he did continue to draw. But we built some stuff into the deck to deal with that. So let's go through the pieces. First, we got this boy. The Android 16s, you just need to run four of them. This card is really good, and it's really good because it has a lot of different utility. You can play it with a rival, and when you play it, your opponent has to discard a card. Your super combo that allows you to play this also makes your opponent bottom deck a card, and you can also combo him for 1k to just tap one to combo him, and when you combo him, he'll also make your opponent drop a card. So he's good for pressuring hand. He's also dual attack revenge blocker, which is just really good. This guy's got a lot of skills. You need to run four of him in the deck because he is your energy. As soon as you see this card, you know it's going straight into your energy, or it's going to be comboed out of your hand to make your opponent discard. The other 16 that is in the deck is this seven drop. So this guy's really good also, and he's also just a dedicated energy. But if you tap four to play him with a rival, he will come into play. He's double strike. He makes your opponent discard a card, and he plays Bad Omen out of your deck. So when he comes into play, you get to search your deck, add an Android 21 five cost or less to your hand, and then play that Android 21 from your hand. So if you have this in your hand already and you search for one, you'll just have two of them and you get to play one. Bad Omen is really great. If you guys don't know what this card does, you can either play it from your energy area or you can play it off this skill. So when you play this card, you get to discard an energy, and if you do, you get to kill one of your opponent's battle cards and kill one of their life. So battle card and a life go straight to the drop area when she comes into play. So if you can get your opponent into range of three life, play this guy, she comes out, gets rid of that one life, and then you have a double striker that also makes them discard a card when he hits. So we play four of the Android 16s and three Bad Omens in the deck. Now let's get into the Android 18 package. So Android 18 really makes this deck work and go off. So let's go into the cards that we play. Four speedy substitution, and this card's amazing because turn one, you can just play it and you'll very likely find a super combo. You look through the top five and you can grab an Android. But she's really good for searching your pieces. So for one energy, you play her, search your pieces, and you also have 5k combo power on the board if you need to later, or a potential swing if you need to pressure a little unison or something like that. Super combos are amazing. The super combo is so good. It gives you your rival blue green for without having to pay an energy cost, and it forces your opponent to place a card on the bottom of their deck, but it only works when you play it from hand. So if you're playing this from the drop area, you won't get the bottom decking a card skill off of it, but having a super combo active on your leader's awaken side on every turn is a pretty amazing move. The Android 18s, I got four of them in here, and I just run them because this is a good option just to draw cards. On turn three, you can awaken, so you can get an energy back usually pretty consistently. And if you play her on turn three, she'll get you two cards. If you swing with your leader, you discard and you draw two. So you're seeing four new cards if you play this card and you're still unawakened on your turn three. So this is just a really good card to just help your hand size, and it's a pitch if you want to draw off your leader swing. Android 18, let the battle begin. I'm considering running more of this card. This card's really good, but you need a unison live for it to really get the value out of it. So when you have your unison up and you have an energy open, you can counterplay with her and she bottom decks a card and comes in as a blocker. So just really useful counterplay. Android 18 full rage, I had this at two and I cut it to one. Kill Rota becomes a temptation, but I think this is just a really good late game play. If your opponent is investing a lot in something that's less than four energy, you just play her, activate battle, bounce that card back to your opponent's hand, and then they kind of don't have anything that they can do. She's good at just pressuring your opponent in the right situation, but you have to use her specifically. She's definitely not a good early game play. All right, let's get into the unison package. So I run four Zeno. Now with Zeno, the thing that's tricky about this deck is if you are running Zeno, you have to be really specific about how you sequence playing your Android 16s out of your energy area. You don't want to ramp with Zeno until you use your arrival on your 16s, because once you ramp with Zeno, you can't replace energy in your energy area. So you want to play Zeno, do your arrivals, get all your arrivals done, and at the end of your turn, then you want to ramp. And then that gets the markers on Zeno. You may use that one energy for a speedy substitution. You may use that energy to bean and get two other energy back so you can arrival on your next turn. But Zeno's really useful because it's an early unison. If you see him on two, this deck can really hit its curve because you have access to your counterplays and so on. We mainboard two heroic prospects. Definitely play two more on the sideboard. If you are playing against a deck that you need this card in, this card just protects the deck. It's such a good card. So we run two in the main. And you know, Trunks has a lot of interaction with the androids and the Dragon Ball series, so it's fun to have things that are thematically similar in the deck. And then we got two God Sealing techniques. The God Sealing technique is just a really good card. I run more in the sideboard. If you need it and you're going to see it, then you add more in the deck if that's when it's going to give you utility. But having access to the Android 18 and God Sealing in one turn can really force your opponent into some difficult situations to manage their energy. Of course, run four beans. The beans are so good. Bean is so good in this deck because if you ramp with Zeno and you bean off your Zeno energy, you can tap your Zeno energy to activate the bean and then untap two of your other mana. So it's essentially getting two mana back that you'll get to keep, and then your Zeno energy goes away at the end of the turn. So bean is really good, really helps with arrivaling stuff, and it's just a fantastic card in this deck. Definitely running four is a move. I know this sound probably going to sound a little crazy, but I only run three dimension magic, and the reason why is because the silver bullets are out there. Game one, they're probably not going to play the silver bullets, but you don't really need to demagic in this deck that much. It's really nice to have access to it and to untap two and have your energy to arrival your 16s is really excellent. So for that reason, it's definitely a very useful card, but there are things that are built into the game now that just really slow this negate down. So sometimes you don't need it and it ends up being a charge, and that's why I run two of the chilled army reinforcement, because this is also a free negate. If you're at five or less, you can take a life and you get to create a blocker. So you get to negate the attack and you get to make a blocker. I saw somebody played me with this yesterday and I was just like, that's really good. So I cut dimension magic to three and I put this to two. Now, this is the finisher of the deck. So I don't play the energy amplification Android 16 because it doesn't allow you to play 30k cards. And what you need the 30k cards for in this deck is what I think is the best win condition in the Dragon Ball Super card game right now. Son Goku, Protector of the Earth. Play three of these, and the reason why is because you really want to see two. On turn five, you play him, bounce their board, and they can't swing with battle cards unless they bottom deck one. So it allows them to put a pretty big investment in to swing. And then if you're able to play another one, you get the effect to a linger through turn six. You could potentially bounce their board again, or you can draw cards if you need to. But I really want to see two of these cards on turn five and turn six. And that's why I run three, is because I'll be likely to see at least two of them by that turn if I'm running three. Now, if you're able to bounce their board on turn five and you still have some markers and they don't kill this guy, on turn seven, you minus two again, you bounce their board back to your hand, you tap seven and play Android 17, turning the tide. if you are able to pull that sequence off, there's very little your opponent can do to get out of that, because Android 17 Terrain of the Tide sends both you and your opponent's hands back to your deck. You shuffle them back into your deck, and then you basically just outrun them and overpressure them. This guy's got 30k crit, you hit him with a crit, and then, you know, you have your unison swing. You may even be able to draw for unison if you didn't have to bounce their board. And you usually have your leader swing, your unison swing, and this guy's swing. So, you know, hitting them for three life and pressuring like that, they usually can't do much to get out of it. Now, of course, the secret rare run, Baby Hatchiak, best secret rare in the game. This sometimes can buy you that turn if you're not able to get another unison off on turn six. You can Baby Hatchiak. And if you're playing the mirror match, of course, you want to have one Baby Golden Avenger to counter that counter. I do have a winner stamp version of this coming in. Shout out to Jerry Bishop. Thank you for the winner stamp. I don't have it in this video, but I'll definitely do another deck profile at some point with this when we update it. And by that time, I will have the one. So shout out to you, Jerry. Thanks for hooking me up with that winner stamp, Baby Golden Avenger. But that's a deck. I would love to hear what you guys think about it. If you've been trying any stuff from Battle Evolutions, I know TM is also really fun to play. But this deck, I think, has a lot of versatility, a lot of different ways to build it. And when those promos come out, it's going to become, I think, a really, really powerful deck. It's going to be very consistent and have more removal options and just a really good all-around deck. Joey Palladino over at Crossworld CCG also has a great deck list on this using some green-yellow stuff. It's pretty spicy, kind of hard to deal with also, but I would check that out as well. If this is your first time here and you enjoy this deck profile and you want to see some shrippums on a weekly basis, make sure to hit that subscription button. And if you are a returning member of the Joe Crew, thanks for checking this out. I hope you guys give this a try. I think it's a really, really fun deck to play. Really interesting sequencing stuff. And blue is just a great, fun color to play. I think Bandai loves blue. And, you know, they heard it with those silver bullets. But I think deep down, they really love the color. Anyway, I am Joku DMD. I can't end the episode without doing a dental tooth tip. So here's the tip of the day, guys. Make sure to wash your toothbrush well. This thing's gonna get nasty. You know, if you have a powered toothbrush, take the head off and really wash it inside, because it's toothpaste and saliva gets in there and gets crusty and it gets gross. And you don't want to be cleaning your mouth with a gross, dirty thing. So make sure you're rinsing off your toothbrush really well after every time you use it. Clean it, dry it off, put it away, because if there's water hanging out in there, it can grow mildew and stuff like that. Anyway, guys, I hope this helps. It's been a pleasure hanging out with you here, and I will see you guys next time.